Hi everyone, and welcome to this video about flashing a BIOS on Windows or Linux using a CH341a MiniProgrammer. Without a working BIOS, even the most powerful hardware cannot be brought to life. That's also what I experienced recently on my X1 Yoga. Somehow, probably after I messed around too much, it ended up with a corrupt BIOS. So all I got when I tried to turn on the device was a blank screen and spinning fans. After reading quite a bit on the internet and getting myself a MiniProgrammer, I was able to flash a working BIOS and get the device up and running again. In this video, I'll try to explain you how I managed to do this by repeating the process on a Dell T1700. But before we get started, I'd like to point out that you can find all information I will share here and much more on my blog, jensz.be, for which you can find a link in the description. So if you plan to go through this process, I really recommend you to have a look there. There are several ways to update or flash the contents of the BIOS chip. The easiest one is on a working system, but since you ended up here, I assume that's no longer a possibility. Let's have a look first at what equipment we need to get through this process. So first of all, you need a programmer itself. So for this video, I will use the CH341A, which is pretty popular and easy to find on eBay or Amazon or even AliExpress. And then to connect the BIOS chip to the programmer, you can use its socket like this one, but this will require you to remove the BIOS chip from the motherboard. And although it's not that much work to desolder it from the board, it's a lot easier if you can leave it on the board and use a clamp, for example, like this, to put on the chip while it's still on the board, which makes it a lot easier for testing the changes you wrote to the BIOS chip. In terms of software, for Windows, I will use AsProgrammer. And for Linux, I will use flashrom, which is part of most Linux distributions repositories. Next up is probably the hardest part, and that is to find the location of the BIOS or SPI chip on the motherboard. This can be tricky, as there are different type of BIOS chip packages around. In my limited experience, most of the time, a soldered 8-pin SOIC is used. This was the case for the Lenovo X1 Yoga, but also for the Dell Precision T1700 and some other systems I checked. Once we found the IC, we need to identify it. This isn't always very easy as well, as it's small and the label is not always readable. What helped for me was to take a macro picture and zoom in. For the X1 Yoga, I simply did a search on Google and I found what I was looking for. On the located SOIC, often indicated by SPI, it's important that we identify pin 1. Usually this is indicated by a dot on the IC itself. This dot needs to match with the red wire of the clip. On the programmer, we need to respect the location of pin 1 as well. For the CH341A, this is near the middle, as is indicated on the back. Make sure the red wire matches with the correct pin when inserting the clip into the programmer. Next up in the process is to make sure that the BIOS chip is not receiving any power. For a laptop, this means disconnecting or disabling the battery. For a desktop, it simply means removing the power cord. Then we can connect the clip to the IC. Finally, we can connect the programmer to our PC, and I really recommend to use a USB extension cable here. Both because the USB connect on the programmer looks pretty fragile, and it makes it easier to disconnect or connect the programmer to your PC. Now that everything is connected properly, let's start with the process in Windows and launch AsProgrammer. Once it's started, click the 7th icon with the question mark. This will try to detect the type of IC that is connected to the programmer. In most cases, a rough indication can be made, but it's still necessary to select the correct type. This is why we needed to identify the chip type after locating it. Select the matching type from the list and start with the first attempt to read the data from the chip by clicking on the 3rd icon with the green arrow. Reading the data takes a few minutes. Once completed, we can see the contents of the IC and hex on the screen. Save this file to a known location and repeat the process to read all data for a second time. The main reason to repeat this is because once the second attempt is done, we'll compare the data. This way, we can be sure that communication between the chip and our PC is working as expected and that the data which we read is matching the chip's contents. Now that the second attempt is done, we can compare the files by generating an MD5 checksum. On Windows, this can be done using certutil.
All looks fine here, as both checksums are matching, so we can be sure that the saved files are a proper backup of the chip's contents. Next, let's open a file in AsProgrammer. This would be the file you want to write to the IC, so a known good BIOS backup or a modified file. Then we can write the contents of it to the BIOS chip by clicking on the fourth icon and choose Unprotect Erase Program Verify. Writing data to the IC takes quite a bit longer than reading. If all goes well, we can read the data once more. When reading is done, save everything to a file again. Finally, we can compare it with the written file, so we are sure that the data in the IC is exactly what we wanted it to be. Since both checksums are a match, all seems fine. After going through all of this on Windows, let me repeat the same for Linux. The process is exactly the same, we'll just be using a different CLI tool called flashrom. We can simply install flashrom from Debian's base repositories. The same tool is, by the way, also available on Windows if you like it. Now that flashrom is installed, we can launch it, trying to read the data from the BIOS chip connected to the programmer. As you can see, just like with AsProgrammer in Windows, flashrom cannot detect the exact chip type, and we need to supply it as an argument to the command we execute. When doing so, we can see flashrom is trying to read the data from the BIOS IC. I did notice that this takes a lot longer compared with Windows. Not sure why. The data got written to backup1.bin, and, as we did before, it's better to perform a second reading attempt. Again, this is to verify if the data which we read is consistent and communication between the PC and BIOS IC works fine. On completion, we can compare the MD5 checksum of both files. Looks like we have a match again, so it's safe to write data to the chip. Provide the name of the file for which you want the data to flash to the BIOS chip on a command. Again, this would be a working backup or a modified BIOS which you want to end up in the IC. After some patience and when writing to the chip is finished, we can do an additional check by reading the data again. Once completed, we can compare the checksum of the data which we read from the IC with the data we asked to be written there, just to be sure. The checksums are a match, and this is exactly what we wanted to see. This completes the Linux part.
Thanks a lot for watching. I really hope this video can help you in case you experience problems. If you liked it, please put a thumbs up. And if you like this or similar content, please don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel. As I mentioned, I also have a blog, jensd.be, for which you can find a link in the description. Thanks again, and I hope to see you back here soon.